In the past week, Spotify has unveiled a new feature for everyone, and it's pretty much like a pay-to-play service that they're offering for artists in order to basically boost your song, get it promoted out to more people. Let's talk about it. What are the pros? What are the cons? Is it good? Let's find out. You know that we coming liars. I'm gonna keep praying to Gaia. Tell those little niggas stop it. Tell my mama that I got this. You know that we coming liars. What's going on? It's Pimp Fried Rice. Welcome to the Music in the Millions podcast, the show where we give independent rappers the tools and resources needed to be successful without waiting on a record label. Like I said, guys, Spotify has unveiled a new feature, and it's an interesting feature. There's a lot of people saying negative things about it. There's a lot of people saying good things about it. So I kind of just wanted to unpack it for you guys and give you my thoughts on it, give you some of the details that I read about it and learned about it from watching videos and checking it out. That way you guys have as much information as possible and you can decide for yourself whether it's good or bad. Let's get right into it. So basically the new feature that Spotify has rolled out is essentially you take less money in return for your songs being streamed and being played, so you take less royalties, but Spotify is going to boost your song out to more people so it's discovered by more people. So they're going to put it into new playlists, they're going to add it on to like the new music discovery, not necessarily those specific playlists, but they're going to push it out to new playlists, that way more people who have never heard of you get a chance to check out your stuff. But like I said, you're going to get less in your royalties, which is unfortunate because, of course, with Spotify, you're already getting 0.0003 cents per stream, which is extremely small. I mean, you're getting a micro fraction of a penny, but now you're going to get even less than that if you choose to have this feature turned on. Now, the cool part is you don't have to have this feature turned on. It's not like Spotify's forcing everyone to be involved with this promotion. They're strictly calling it an experiment right now, and they're allowing you the option to turn it on or off if you want to. Which is cool because you can at least then, you know, turn it on, see how it works, and then turn it off if it's not going well. But they at least give you that option so that way you're not just stuck with one thing or the other. The cool part is that it works for artists and labels at any level. You don't have to be an established label. You don't have to be an established artist. You could literally be Joe Schmo off the streets, have a microphone, just recorded your first song, and then you can turn on this promotion on Spotify. Now the thing with that is, they're not guaranteeing that your song is going to get played. So just because you submit it into this promotion does not mean that Spotify is going to boost it forward and put it on playlists, because they're going to make sure the quality of the song is good. If the quality doesn't match up to other songs on Spotify, they're basically going to shelve it right away. They're not going to push it forward to more people. There's going to be a lot of different factors that the algorithm is going to be looking for to put your song into more playlists, because guys, it is done algorithmically. It's not like there's someone just sitting in a room listening to 1,000 songs every single day, just like, oh, okay, no, let's put this one here, let's put this one over here. That's not happening. It's literally AI, it's a computer, it checks out a couple different information points on your song and then picks the best playlist and place for that song to be put. Now that is cool, because obviously if you're a starting off artist, you can take advantage of this feature. And if you are a label, you still can take advantage of this feature as well. So that's dope. And the cool part also is that it doesn't require any upfront budget because of the fact that they're taking the royalties on the back end. So this is cool for the artists who are just starting out, like I said, and they may not necessarily have a bunch of money to put into promotion for ads on Facebook and Instagram and YouTube and Google. But now they can start to get their music put on playlists through this promotion because it doesn't require anything out of their pocket up front, which is a really cool feature about it. Because now, if you want to find out if a song's going to do good, if you want to kind of test the waters with a song, you can do that by selecting to turn that feature on. Spotify's going to boost it into the other playlists and everything like that, and you can see, is this song going to perform well or is this one not going to do as well as the other ones? And if that song continues to do well, you have that option. Do I want to leave this feature turned on and have Spotify keep promoting it and keep promoting it and keep promoting it? You can do that. If the song's not performing well, you have the option to turn that feature off. That way, you're not just going to keep wasting your royalties and wasting, you know, Spotify's efforts to try and get the song out if it's not connecting. Now, this does mean with everything being algorithmic and everything looking at different aspects of the song, you want your song to be the highest quality possible. You don't want to put out mediocre songs because there's a chance it will get shelved very quickly. A couple of the things that Spotify's looking for when they do place your song in a playlist is other artists like you, like based off of similar, you know, things about your artist page. They're going to be looking for the length of the song. They're going to be looking for the instruments involved in the song. They're going to be time of day that the song is uploaded, day of upload, time of day that people like to listen to the song, the energy levels of the song. Different things like this are all different points that the algorithm is going to be looking at to see, okay, should I put it on the new music discovery, or should I put it on, you know, a workout playlist? Should I put it on lo-fi vibes? But this is all going to be done based off of a bunch of different points. And Spotify actually linked an article, which I'll link down below so you guys can check it out, that talked about some of the key points they're going to be looking for with this algorithm. Now, like I said, though, you are not guaranteed plays just because you submit your song to this new feature. So you want to be sure that you're keeping track. Is my song doing well, or is my song not doing well? If your song is not performing, if it's not gaining stream numbers, there's a very good chance that Spotify could have shelved your song. I don't know if they're going to make you aware if your song gets shelved. I would hope that they do. There wasn't anything in the article or any of the videos that I watched that said if your song is shelved or pulled or they're not going to push it, that they'll let you know so that way you're not just like sitting there like a sitting duck. I hope that they do, but as of right now, there's no information on that. And because it's done algorithmically, Spotify is using it, like I said, they're calling this an experiment right now, so that way they're kind of testing the waters to see if this works, and I guess they're hoping to eventually have more artists participate in this. But right now, a lot of the main songs that are being involved in the promotion are being discovered on radio and autoplay, because they already know that their fans and the listeners on those two categories are looking for new music. They're the type of people that want to hear new artists, they want to check out new stuff, so they're sending it to those places first to kind of test the waters, see if this new feature is working, and then they're going to unveil it and start putting it in, you know, playlists and stuff like that. That way people can discover new music all the time. Now my question is this good for artists or is this bad for artists? And to be honest, I wouldn't necessarily call this bad. I know there's a lot of people who are saying that this is payola, this is pretty much like back in the days when they were doing all this type of stuff, which is illegal, which if you guys don't know what payola is, back in the days of like when radio was really big, record labels would actually pay certain radio DJs. They would like grease their pockets, give them a little money, like, hey, play our single, send it out to more DJs, get this as many spins as possible. Well, that is illegal. Just like paying to have your song on a Spotify playlist is illegal, this is kind of Spotify's like workaround and loophole to that, because technically you're not paying to have them promote your song, because that is illegal. What you're doing is they're promoting your song and you're entering a partnership with Spotify where they're saying, we're going to boost you out there, but we're also going to take a little extra cut of the money. So they're kind of working around the loophole of payola there. They're dancing on a gray line there, but I wouldn't necessarily call it bad. This is neither good nor bad at this point. This is something that as artists, you should be testing to see if it works with you and your brand. This is something you should see if it fits, if it's something you actually enjoy working with. Because if it doesn't line up with you and your brand, there's no point for you using it regardless. And there is a lot of good features about this, like the fact that there is the no upfront budget, so that's cool for people who don't have money to promote their music. It's cool that you can do it at any level. It doesn't matter if you're wildly successful or if you're just starting off. That's a really cool feature. I like that you can turn it on and off, so like maybe you want to get a song out there, you want to try and give it that initial boost as soon as you drop it. You could turn the feature on, let Spotify work their magic, maybe for a month or two, let that song get a little bit of traction, and then once people are starting to enjoy it, you can actually turn that feature off and now collect the actual amount of royalties that you're supposed to be getting now that that song kind of has the legwork already done and you can do your promotion on top of it. So there is a lot of really cool features. There's a lot of features where it's kind of like, we're going to have to see how this plays out. So as of right now, I can't give you guys a definite answer. Is it good? Is it bad? What I can tell you is it's a new feature that you should at least look into for yourself. Try to find out as much information on. Let me know down in the comments below, guys. Is this payola? Is this something that you are going to completely avoid as an artist? Or is this something that you're like, I don't know, this seems like a good idea, I'm going to test it out. Let me know down below. I'm curious to see who's on the good side, who's on the bad side. Let me know. Guys, thanks for watching today's episode. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell. We're getting on our way to 500 subscribers. We're getting there little by little. By the end of the year, I want to hit that 500 mark, though, so I know we can do it. Let's get it. Have a great weekend. Peace.